A new adaptive traffic control system is geared to reduce travel times and adapt to traffic flow.
So as the city continues to grow, as we open new roadways, this will become important because the routes that people take are ever-changing.
That's our goal, is we're trying to improve travel time and reduce their delays.
City of Frisco engineers are working to get a new traffic control system up and running along Preston Road to help improve traffic flow through that area.
The adaptive system is supposed to be able to detect if we get variations in traffic, because we all know it's not the same every day. And so this is going to allow us to do that.
The new system uses radars to move traffic along and across Preston Road at the intersections of Lebanon Road, John Hickman, Warren, and Gaylord Parkways. A different type of sensor, small round devices called magnetometers, have been placed in the ground at the intersection of Gaylord Parkway and Mall Road F near Stonebriar Center to help better control traffic into the mall. The system uses these sensors to detect the traffic flow, then changes the lights to keep it moving more efficiently.
This is what the computer program can do. It can move the green time continuously to the direction, the street that needs it, and then back to the other street if it needs it a little bit later.
And as more people move to Frisco, our roadways will only become busier.
Yeah, so as the city grows, this is becoming increasingly important. So Frisco has been fortunate to have good support in the bond program, and we've been able to build roads ahead of traffic. Now it's on the traffic signal and the technology, the software, to squeeze just a little bit more out of those roads.
Frisco is one of only a few cities in North Texas to use this type of system to move traffic.
We're going to spend the next 12 months doing an evaluation on it and learning, you know, one, if it can work, and then if it does work, you know, does it maybe work better under certain conditions than others or other locations?
Federal funds and voter-approved bonds paid for the updated system, which may be expanded to more intersections in the future.
That's our goal at the end, or, you know, determine if it's going to work, and then under what conditions it works best, so then we can decide where else that we should